country. Oh, it's like an animal farm. That's a real old charm in the country. He's got money.
Thoughts on the year so far would be, I mean, it's been a tough year for everyone involved in any walk of life, any sport. But I think I started the year very well, obviously off the back of the Worlds last year. It was a massive positive, and then I was playing some good stuff at the start of the year, and then obviously lockdown hit and it knocked my routine and stuff out a bit. I got a little bit lazy on the board and whatever, but I think I'm starting to throw some good stuff again now. I'm feeling good on the board, feeling good in game. So yeah, not a great year, not as well as I'd hoped it had gone, but considering the circumstances, and it can't be wrong. I hopefully have a good end to the year. I've got a few mates on tour, but probably my closest mate on tour is probably Callum Ridge. We room together. We go and play snooker. Obviously, in normal circumstances, we go and play snooker together. We pretty much always, when we're weekends away, we spend a hell of a lot of time together. So I'll probably say Cal. I sit on the same table as Wayne Jones and Alan Tabern as well. So that's always fun, and always a few laughs going on. And Josh Payne as well, good friends with Josh. There's quite a few lads on tour really. So, but yeah, probably Callum, yeah. Hobbies away from darts would be, I like playing golf, not very well, but I like playing golf. I go out on my mountain bike quite a bit into the forest and stuff. It's normal stuff really, spending time with the family. I like playing on the Xbox on FIFA and stuff, yeah, that's about it really. Funniest moment, probably, it actually happened to me. I'm going back a few years now. It was when the Pro Tours were in Crawley. I didn't even have my tour card then, but we got like asked to play, obviously, off the Q School Order of Merit, like the rankings. Playing in Crawley in the day, me and my manager went out for a few drinks on the night time. I don't know if anyone's been to Crawley. It's like a big strip. Bars and sort of like takeaways, stuff either side. Anyway, end of the night, Mark goes, oh, I fancy such takeaway. I fancied another one. He went over one side of the road, I went the other. And down the middle of this road was like, obviously dividing, it was like a metal fence. Me, obviously after having a few drinks and stuff, in my wisdom, thought it was a good idea to try and hop this fence with my bag of food in my hand. I've gone to swing my legs over it. I've clipped the top of my feet on the railings, nosedived into the grass, managed to keep my food without spilling it everywhere. As I walked into this take where my manager was, Mark started laughing and said I looked like someone out of Wurzel Gummidge. I had grass in my hair, and to make matters worse as well, I think there was a fair few people queuing up for all the bars and pubs and stuff. So yeah, that's probably the one of the funniest moments. Most memorable moments, it's got to be the World Championships last year to make my debut on at the Ali Pali, and to obviously beat Paul Lim and then go on to beat Michael Smith was fantastic. It obviously meant I kept my tour card, and it just gave me a massive boost and a massive confidence with my game, and just showing I can compete at a really good level. So that's definitely the most memorable moment for me, and I'd probably put the Dowell Gurney win at the Players sort of alongside it. And then other than that, probably actually getting my tour card a few years ago now, and that was such a big achievement for me at the time, because I didn't have a lot of belief to begin with, and it was a huge achievement for me. Pizza all day long, pizza, pepperoni pizza especially, and or the free cheese pizza. But I'm not, to be honest, not a huge steak fan. It's not something I'd usually order. So yeah, pizza. I wouldn't say I had a darts idol. My favourite player growing up was Adrian Lewis. Say growing up, he's not a lot older than me, but my favourite player to watch was Adrian Lewis, and I like watching Wayne Mardell and Colin Lloyd as well. I just like people that sort of made the game look quite easy, that sort of entertained as well as played as well, which is a bit opposite to what I do, but I like watching them. They're interesting to watch, they're fun to watch, so yeah. Aims for 2021. To be honest, I'm not really a massive target setter. I probably should be a bit more than I do, but my aim's really just to get a lot more consistent on the tour and sort of really push on and make more quarters, semis, finals, maybe even win one, and just show that, do you know what I mean, that it's not something that just happens every so often. I just want to get more consistent, keeping that top 64 in the world, and then just keep pushing on and get as good as I can. I'm a realist too. Sort of, I'd rather it take a few years for me to get there than rather it sort of be a flash in the pan and whatever. So yeah, just more consistency in my game, and if I can sort of get towards that top 32 in the world, then that'll be wicked. And I mean, hopefully next year's a lot better year than this year, as in we're sort of back to some normality. Jeans and like a t-shirt, not even a shirt. I'm not someone that really goes the old trousers, but yeah, definitely just like jeans and a t-shirt, joggers and whatever. I think I'm more for just lounging about and just chilling out, but yeah, jeans and a t-shirt.
Oh, it's a century's remedy.